Knowledge is power, and when it comes to retirement, you really need to have the knowledge, and that's why I love having Marcus Warren on the show from Warren Wealth Management, because Marcus is a fantastic resource. And today, Marcus, first of all, I guess welcome back in.
Thank you.
I got the blue memo, but yeah, you look much more handsome in it. It's starting to make me a little mad. I'm a little upset about it, but no, you look fantastic.
Thanks.
Okay, today we're talking about puzzle. Yeah. And as you know, when there's a puzzle, some are easy, some are hard, and sometimes it's hard to know how to put pieces together. So I like the analogy, because when it comes to retirement, you got a lot of pieces, right?
Yeah, there are a lot of pieces to the retirement puzzle, and the issue is trying to make sure that they all fit together. And when we talk about these puzzle pieces, or these retirement puzzle pieces, you have things like the investment piece, right, where I think most people put most of their focus on. You know, they're focused on their investments. And as you get closer to retirement, you need to start thinking, you know, how much risk do I have in my portfolio? Should I move to safer investments? Because you still want to get a good solid rate of return, but you want to take at least the least amount of risk as possible, because what you don't want to happen is you don't want to retire and then immediately the market goes down, because that can have a significant effect on your retirement nest egg once you retire. So you have that piece. You have the Social Security piece. You know, when should you take Social Security? At 62? By the way, most people take it at 62, by the way. Should you wait until full retirement age, which is 66 or 67? And then, of course, you can wait till 70 when you get those enhanced benefits. And then, of course, there's the spousal benefits that go along with Social Security. So it's like, how can you maximize that Social Security piece of the puzzle? And then there's healthcare. We know that Medicare kicks in at 65. Medicare kicks in, but we know that that doesn't cover everything. So you're going to need some sort of supplemental coverage to cover Medicare. So there's that healthcare issue. Then of course you have the insurance puzzle piece. You have an insurance puzzle piece, meaning that should you have life insurance? Should you have long-term care insurance? Long-term care insurance is huge and important once you retire. A couple that's 65, they have a great possibility of having to be in some sort of long-term care facility than they did when they were younger. So should you have long-term care insurance? There's the tax piece, of course. I talked about taxes
Monster
all the time.
Piece, yeah.
And of course, when you're in retirement, a lot of people are in shock because they find out that they're paying just as much in taxes, and sometimes more in taxes than they were when they were working. So there are a lot of pieces to that puzzle, and how you get it together is important.
Yeah, it's complex. And for those who, maybe you say, well, you know what, I've got an accountant over here and I think he knows a little bit about retirement,
right,
and what I'm trying to accomplish. And maybe I have a wealth management person over here, but that's what's nice about what you do at Warren Wealth Management. You can handle all things and under one roof.
Yep.
And to me, that means a lot, because sometimes two people may not think in the same direction. You're looking out for your clients and you're saying, because I have all this knowledge, I'm going to help you achieve your retirement goals.
Yeah, so there's a lot of organizations and entities, you know, competing for that dollar bill. You have the banks, you have the insurance companies, you have Wall Street or the brokers, and then you have your insurance agents. And then, of course, trying to manage all that and put all that together can be daunting for a lot of clients. And so what we've decided to do is we've decided to say, you know what, how about a one-stop shop where we look at the tax piece, we look at the insurance piece, we look at the investment piece, where clients know that they can go to that one specific location and they're not getting competing ideas and arguments on how to invest that dollar or when to take a withdrawal because of taxes. We know it all. We do it all in-house.
Okay. This is why you should give them a call at Warren Wealth Management. Before I get to this 15-minute phone call that we're going to talk about here, before I get to that, I want to talk a little bit about, for folks who want more information, you have a podcast.
Yeah.
How do they tune into that?
They can go wherever they get their podcast. So Apple Podcast, Spotify, wherever they get their podcast. It's the Marcus Warren Show. Tune in. You'll learn a lot of good, solid information, and you'll be entertained, John. You'll be entertained
yes.
along the way.
And I know your focus is, as it should be, on people who are near retirement age. With that being said, I'm really happy with the fact, and I don't think this is unique to me, that my son seemed to get the fact that, hey, I've got to be on a budget. I've got to put some away for the future. Hopefully, it's a little bit of my influence, but I think people like you have been really good at making younger folks more aware of the importance of putting away and investing and being prepared for this. Would you say that's true?
Yeah, it is true, because you know, when you are first starting out, you're climbing that retirement mountain, so to speak. And so that's important that you start as early as possible. I have most of my clients are retired, generally 65 and over, and I love the stories they tell. I like to sit down with them and just hear about their stories. And then I always ask them the question, if there was one thing that you could change in your investing history, what would it be?
I can
and
guess
they
that answer.
All say, what do you think?
They say, I wish I'd have started earlier.
That's it. They always say that. And so I tell the young adults out there now, even kids who have that first job, you know, put a little bit away, invest it for retirement, whatever it may be. It pays off in the long term. You might not like to take, you know, that little chunk of money and, you know, and put it away. But if you can think long term, and I know it's hard when you're young to think long term, but if you can think long term, it pays off.
And also at the younger age, you can take a little bit more risk. Let's say you're saving 15%. Those guys can go, hey, I'm going to take about 7.5% of this, and I'm going to take some risk with it, and that's okay, because if they lose, they have time to make up the difference, right?
Yes, yeah. That's one of the biggest differences from someone who's close to retirement and someone who's first starting out. When you're first starting out, you can be a lot more aggressive, just like you said, because you have time. If the market dips, that's actually beneficial, because you're putting money in and you can buy at the dips and you're actually buying low, and so you have more time to recover. When you're older, it's different. When you make that transition from working to retirement and you have a distribution or a withdrawal strategy and the market dips and you're pulling money out, it hurts a little bit more than it did when, you know, 20, 30 years ago.
And there are some valuable strategies. I think some folks say, well, you know, I know a little bit about stocks and everything. I've been doing this for, 20, 30 years. But when it comes to retirement, there are strategies to make sure that Uncle Sam only gets his fair piece of the pie.
Right.
To also ensure that, you know, that you avoid some of those tax or take advantage of some of the tax loopholes.
Yes.
And there's other, you know, as far as a way to make your investments work for you. So for folks who would like a 15-minute conversation, we mentioned that. How does that happen? And what kind of information can you give them in that quick period of time?
Well, that 15-minute phone call, if you go to talktomarcus.com, my calendar pops up and we have a lot of these 15-minute slots where we just want to get to know you and your situation to see if we can add value. We find out where you are, find out where you want to be, and then we can see if we can develop that plan to get you there. But you can go to talktomarcus.com, schedule that 15-minute phone call. It'll be worth their while.
You know, we spend a lot of time on the show talking about continuing education. In your business, I would think it would be critical. I'm assuming that you attend a lot of, seminars, that you're probably a part and speak at a lot of these, because it is important to know current tax situation, what's going on there, healthcare situation works into it. Of course, investments work into it. What's hot, what's cold. Talk about that a little bit. Do you enjoy that?
To a certain extent. I mean, you know, I'm a tax enrolled agent, and you know, the tax code, law, and theory, it changes all the time.
Yes.
And so, if you can imagine going into those continuing education classes,
ooh,
and you're there with a bunch of accountants and people who are talking about taxes, you know, it's not a party. You know, it's not a party over there. It's not like, you know, there's a disco ball and everybody's just having a good time. No, it's stoic, but a lot of good information. That's what makes me one of the experts in.
See,
in
and I also think that's why I think you are perfect for someone who wants advice on retirement, because you convey the message well. A lot of people have one side or the other. They're either all left side or all right side brain, and they don't. You can do both. You can talk to and make it to where we, people like myself, layperson, can understand what you're talking about and make it make sense for you.
Yeah.
So the retirement puzzle, once again, it's Marcus Warren, Warren Wealth Management. And if you'd like that 15-minute phone call again, Marcus, I hate to be repetitive, but tell them where to go.
Go to talktomarcus.com. Make sure you are close or in retirement. That's where we can benefit you the most and add the most value. But once again, talktomarcus.com. Brings up my calendar, schedule that call.
Okay, and if you'd like to ask a question to Marcus, you notice we always have a focus on this show.
Yeah.
We could ask your question on the show. All you have to do, you want him to email you or just call that Ask Marcus line right there. That'll work.
Yeah, that's right. The next time I'm on, we're going to have the Ask Marcus show segment. How about that?
Okay.
I'm not going to take over the show, John. You don't have to worry about it.
No.
But Ask Marcus segment.
You're more than welcome.
So if you call that number, leave your question, your voicemail, maybe answer that question, maybe answered. next week.
I think a lot of people might want to know, where do you get all of your clothes? Where do you get your fashion sense, Marcus? That may be one of the questions. Be ready, right?
I'll be ready for it.
Okay. Marcus Warren, Warren Wealth Management. Okay, come